Hello everyone, I am Divyarani Pandurang Babar, working as an assistant professor at AISSMS IOIT Pune. In this presentation, we will try to understand what is power set. Now, for particular set A, a collection of all subset of set A is called as power set of set A. See, power set is nothing but the collection of subset of that particular set. Power set of A is denoted by P of A or 2 to the power A. Or we can represent this power set as P of A is equal to X such that X is a subset of A. Now, consider one example. P of phi is equal to phi. We know that phi is a subset of each and every non-empty set. One more set is there, that is A. It contains only one element, that is A. Then what will be the power set of A? We know that phi is a subset of each non-empty set. So phi is a one subset and that individual element is also subset of that set. So phi comma A is the power set of A. Next one is B is equal to A comma B. So phi is a subset of this set and this set is also subset of this particular set, that means AB. Apart from this, we have to mention each individual element as a subset of that set. That means power set of B is equal to phi, comma A, comma B, comma AB. One more set is there, that is C. C is equal to A, comma B, comma C. Now here, we know that phi is a subset of any non-empty set. Again, this set is also a subset of this set, that means A, B, C. Apart from this, we have to mention each individual element as a subset of that particular set. And we have to combine two elements as a subset of this set. That means phi, comma A, comma B, comma C. Again, we have to make pairs, that is A, comma B, B, comma C, A, comma C, and that particular element is also a subset, that means A, B, C. So this is the power set of C. Now, this is the reason why power set of A is sometimes represented by 2 to the power A. See here, in the set A, we have only one element. Then, suppose you have to find out how many numbers of elements are present in the power set of A. Then you have to use 2 raised to A. That means how many number of elements are present in set A? One element is present. So 2 raised to 1 is equal to 2 elements. 2 elements are present in the power set of A. Now consider second set, that is B. B is equal to A comma B. So two elements are present in the set B. Therefore, power of B has 2 raised to 2 is equal to 4 elements. Hence, if we have n elements in a set A, then P of A must have 2 raised to n elements. Now we will see examples on power set. See the example number 1. Give the power sets of the following. First one is A, comma B. Second one is 1, comma 5. And third one is X, comma Y, comma Z. Now see here, set A contains two elements, that is A, comma B. We have to find out the power set of this set. So power set of A is equal to, we know that phi is a subset of each and every set. So phi. Again, you have to mention each individual element as a subset of that particular set, that means A, comma B. and that particular element is also a subset of that set. So AB. So this is the power set of A. Now let B is equal to 1 comma 5. So power set of B is equal to first subset is 5. Again, each element you have to mention as a subset, that is 1 comma 5. And this particular element is also a subset of that set, that is 1 comma 5. Now let C is equal to x comma y comma z. So power set of C is equal to 5. Apart from this, you have to mention individual element, that is x, y, z. Again, you have to make some pairs, that is x comma y, y comma z, and x comma z. And that particular element is also a subset of that set, that is x, y, z. So this is nothing but the power set of C. Now see this example number 2. Find the power set of each of these sets where A and B are distinct elements. Now, let A is equal to A. So, what will be the power set of A? We know phi is a subset of any non-empty set. So, phi is the first element and second element is A. Now, let B is equal to A comma B. Now, here power set of B is what? Phi. After that individual element, that is A, B, and that particular element, that is A, B. Now let C is equal to 5 comma 5. Now what will be the power set of C? 5. After that each individual element, that is 5 comma 5, and this total element, that is 5 comma 5. This will be the power set of C. Now, see example number 3. Here, question is what? How many elements does each of these sets have where A and B are distinct elements? Here, you have to calculate how many number of elements are present in power set of that particular set. Now, see the first power set, that is P of A comma B comma AB. So we know the formula how to calculate number of elements, that means 2 raised to A, okay, and A is nothing but the number of elements present in the given set. So see here in the first set 3 elements are present, so we have to calculate number of elements present in power set. So 2 raised to 3 is nothing but 8 elements. In the second set, 4 elements are present. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, number of elements present in the power set of A will be 2 raised to 4 is equal to 16 elements. Now, in the third set, that is P of 5, that means set 5 has no elements. So, power set of 5 has one element, which is set 5. So here 2 raised to 1 is equal to 2 elements. That means 2 elements are present in the power set of 5. Now consider one more example. The number of elements in the power set P of S of the set S is equal to 5 comma 1, comma 2, 3. Here are the some options. Option number A is 2. Option number B is 4. Option number C is 8. Option number D is none of the mentioned. This question has been asked in GATE 1995. Now, see the solution here. One set is given, that is S. It contains 3 elements, that is 5, comma 1, comma 2, 3. Okay, so there are 3 elements present in the given set. Just you have to calculate the number of elements in the power set. We know how to calculate this. That means 2 to the power A. So 2 raised to 3 is equal to 8 elements. So How many elements are present here? 8 elements are present in the power set of. Yes. So option 3, option C is the correct option here. Okay. Just we will see what are the elements present in the power set P of S. We know that phi is a subset. So phi, each individual element, that means phi 1, 2, 3. Afterwards, you have to make pair, that means 5, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 2, 3, and that particular element or particular set, that means 5, 1, 2, 3. So, total 8 elements are present in the power set P of S. So, option C is correct. Next problem, for a set A, the power set of A is denoted by 2 to the power A. If A is equal to 5, 6, 7, which of the following options are true? There are 4 options given. This question has been asked in GATE 2015. Now, see the solution here. We know that power set of A is denoted by 2 to the power A. Okay, now set A is given already in the question, that means 5, 6, 7. Here, we have to see what are the elements present in the power set of A. So, power set of A is equal to 2 raised to A. That means, first element is 5, afterwards 5, 6, 7. Apart from this, you have to make some pairs, 5, 6, 6, 7, 5, 7, and that particular set is also a subset of that set, that means 5, 6, 7. So, these are the elements present in the power set of A. Now, we have to check the options. First option is what? 5 belongs to 2 raised to A. Yes, 5 is present in the power set of A. So, first is true. Again, second is what? Phi is a subset of a 2 raised to A. Yes, it is also true because we know that A is a subset of a B if and only if for all X belongs to A implies X belongs to B. So, second condition is also true. Now, third is what? 5, 6 belongs to 2 raised to A. Yes, 5, 6 is present in the power set of A. So, it is also correct. Now, fourth condition is what? 5, C is a subset of 2 raised to A. No, it is not a subset of 2 raised to A. So, this is false. 5, 6 is not a subset of 2 raised to A. So, fourth one is a false. Now, check the options here. Only 1, 2 and 3 is correct. So, option C is correct. So, this is all about the power set. Thank you.